Good afternoon, everyone. So it is about 2:30. It is February 9th. I'll let you out in a second. Marshall's crying because he's in his crate. So very exciting day today. My sister is coming. So in about half an hour, I'm gonna leave for the airport and go pick her up in Raleigh. I cannot freaking wait. Also, very exciting. I put a full face of makeup on for the first time in like over 3 weeks. And I have like a fresh tan. I did my nails. I need to go get my ring. But I am having some breakouts and stuff, but overall, I feel amazing. I washed my hair and curled it. It was like therapeutic doing my hair. But yeah, I'm just so super excited. And I feel like I wear this shirt in every single one. But yeah, we're gonna have a fun like girls weekend. Shh, Bubba, I'm coming. We're gonna have like a fun girls weekend and do some wedding planning and stuff. So I figured I would vlog and show you what all we get up to. So I need to go grab my shoes right now and I feel so bad. Ooh, the lighting is not good. I feel so bad because our house is still an absolute mess and we are just like not prepared, but it's okay, whatever. I'm literally going to dig a pair of sneakers out of a paper box. Like, this is sad. But it is what it is. I'm like digging through these boxes, trying to figure out which one the shoes I want are in. Not any of these. Oh, there they are. Got them. And it is such a beautiful day outside. It's like 66 and sunny, not a cloud in the sky, which I don't know why I'm wearing like a long sleeve and like leggings. But I just wanted to put some comfortable gym clothes on because my tan is still a little bit fresh. I put it on this morning at like 9. So it's been on for like 5 hours, but the one I've been using stays a little bit tacky, which I'm like out of breath. Which I don't like love, but it does give me a really good color. It looks really natural, so I'm just gonna suck it up. So yeah, I'm about to leave for the airport and I have to drop some paperwork off at the leasing office. And yeah, I mean, like, we still have boxes and stuff in our living room, but the whole point is not for us to stay at home. We need to get out and do stuff and explore and have fun. And I think tonight we're gonna get dinner and get drinks, and I'm just so excited. Also, you guys, you need these shoes. Like, these are the most comfortable things in the entire world. Nick actually got me these, and the color is not something I would normally pick, but these are the Nike sock darts, and they are heavenly. Like, they literally are socks. Like, you can see my toes, but they are so comfy.
Marshall, come on. No, you have to sit. You have to sit, buddy. Sit, sit. If you wanna go outside, if you wanna go potty, you gotta sit. No, Marshall, you're doing the opposite of sit. Hey, Bubba, sit. Hey, be good boy. Marshall, come. I know, sis. Okay, get a drink. Come on, Bubba, let's go potty. Nope, you're slobbering everywhere. Ugh. Can you sit nice? Sit. Hey, take a seat. Good boy. Paw. Give me paw. Give me paw. Oh, you're a nut. Come on, let's go outside. Hold on, hold on, hold on. Would you relax? We're all gonna go potty before we get in the car. Hey, 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 hey. Marshall, don't jump on your sister like that. Okay. Oh, you guys are crazy.
Yeah, I got all my pictures there. Hey. Yeah. Woo! Mercy! No, Gloria!
I really didn't know that it was overflowing.
What, did you shake it before? No. I thought you just pulled it out of the fridge. Oh, you guys want some champagne? Oh, Marshy does. He loves champagne. He's licking the bottom of the bottle. Look at him.
Marshall.
Oh my god, that's funny. Shizzy. Cheers. Yay! Is it good?
Oh, it's very good.
Mm.
Brotherhood.
Mm.
Which is good.
Fancy.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Where are we going?
So we are going to get our hair done. Mm-hmm. Our hair and, well, Gloria's getting a makeup trial because I'm doing my own makeup. But we are on the way to Raleigh to go get our hair done. We are stopping for gas and then grabbing some coffee. Why are you getting so close? Oh my god.
Yes, we are.
We're very excited. It is very early. It's 8:16. It's ridiculous. But we have to be there by 10, so we're just gonna stop for breakfast really quick and then get on the road. So we remember what it looks like.
Wedding day steak, I'll use like a clear rubber band.
To yeah, okay.
Like just cool.
Like the curly.
So let's see it, Loren. I was so awful and forgot to freaking tape while we were in there.
I did a little bit, it's fine.
You did a little bit? Well, it looks great.
Thanks. I don't know, I wanted to get the updo just to like confirm that I didn't
did,
want
yeah, that you didn't want it or whatever.
Let's you know, see. I don't know. I mean, like I do like a messy updo, but this is too.
This is mine.
I think it's like too done up for me.
I don't like this camera because I'm like looking down. I don't know where to look.
You know what I mean? It's like too like.
Yeah.
Bridal.
It is very bridal.
Like my style is more like messy. Cheers.
Glasses.
I know, we're already done. Do you like your hair? Can we get a side view? I think it needs to go up higher on your head, like up here. Yeah. I like it though. Do you like it? Your makeup looks pretty. You like the lashes? Let me see you turn. You can't see it in this light. It looks good in this light. Yeah.
Loren.
Let me see your toes.
You've
done me well.
You're a freak.
Just here to entertain you.
Clearly.
Yeah, but we are at the dog park.
I know, yeah. Go get it.
Yay!
Marcy,
come here, Bubba.
Good boy.
How's your food?
Delicious.
I had pokey. It was so good.
Okay.
Poke. I call it pokey. What up?
Just driving.
You chauffeuring me?
We are currently on our way to Raleigh again. Monday. We're gonna go look for some shoes and then we have to do linen rentals. We're gonna go pick out tablecloths and napkins. It's very exciting. And then you're leaving me. It's kind of a crappy day today.
It's gross.
It's a very crappy day today. It's very rainy. They might be a little bit big though.
Those are cute. Looking for wedding shoes.
They're such a granny heel, but I don't want anything too high. You know?
Yeah.
I think that looks really pretty. It's like a burlappy. Are you having a DJ or a band? Oh, wait, these ones.
Oh, no, you're right.
Yeah, I think that looks really pretty. Like the satin.
Mm-hmm.
I'm gonna show them the velvet.
Can we like the satin one on the velvet, correct?
Yes, please.
Beautiful. And did you want to look at any chargers for the sweetheart table?
I did, yes.
And are you looking? We have all.
Yes. This is gonna look so good. Really pretty. Yeah, it looks good with the satin napkin. Mm-hmm. That's what I like all the textures and yeah, that's pretty.
It looks so scary because the sauce is so dark.
Amazing.
It is amazing.
I'm so sad. Don't leave.
It won't be long though until we see each other next.
I know. You got your bag and everything?
Yeah. Everything.
Okay. I love you so much. Thank you for coming.
Thanks for everything, Lily. This was a lot of fun. Like I said, love you.
Have a safe flight, okay? Text me when you land and like if you get delayed or anything else, okay? Okay. Hey guys, so it is currently the next day. What day is it? I don't even know. What day is it, buddy, huh? What day is it? I dropped my sister off at the airport yesterday, as you will see in the vlog, and we did some shoe shopping, and we went and picked out linens, and we went for lunch, and then I dropped her off. She did have an early evening flight. So you're gonna see the clips of the linens from the rental place, but my plan is to put them in black and white because I don't wanna give away everything or like all the colors and all that stuff. So if you see them in black and white, that's why. So yeah, I just wanted to kinda wrap up this vlog. I'm trying to be better about doing intros and outros because I usually forget those. So just to summarize kind of what we did, I didn't do a ton of vlogging. I really wanted to get the main points of like the hair trial and the linen rentals. Those were kind of like the big things that I wanted to hit on because they were, you know, wedding related and all of that stuff. Because, you know, we really just wanted to spend some time together. We did dinner, we got drinks, all that kind of stuff. It was really fun. So I didn't want to vlog that kind of stuff. I didn't want to whip out my camera in the middle of like a restaurant or while we're, you know, chatting and all that kind of stuff. But to wrap up this vlog, I wanted to quickly talk to you guys about what I've been using to plan this wedding and keep myself organized. I have gotten a few questions about what wedding planner I'm using, and I'm actually sitting here doing some work right now at my computer. So I figured now would be a really, really good time to show you my planner. So I'm a huge fan of the Erin Condren, is that what it's called? Erin Condren planner. So this is what I have, and you can customize the front, but it costs extra, so I just got like this whatever. So it's really nice quality. It's laminated. You have your rings here, so everything is kept together super easy. And so it just says wedding planner, wedding date, all that kind of stuff. And then on the sides here, you have your month tabs. And what I really liked about this one is that you can specify the date range. So since we're getting married in August, I don't need a planner that goes all the way till December. It's kind of a waste. So this one actually started September 2018 and it goes to August 2019, which is perfect. So it is a full year. It does go a full calendar year, but it goes the year that you need. So you can pick your specific months like that. So just to give you guys an example of kind of what I'm doing, this is my month of February. It's a little bit crazy. I had a really busy month. So you basically can write in whatever you need. I have to-do lists here. I have notes back here, all that kind of stuff. And it comes with fun little stickers where you can add like to-do and exclamation point, that kind of stuff. It's really cute. And then you do have this little divider to keep you on the correct month. So yeah, I've just really been writing down like notes. This is where I've been keeping, you know, tabs on what events I have, what I need to get done, all that kind of stuff. It's super easy, super straightforward. So the first part of this, like I said, is really just a calendar. You know, I'm planning things all the way up until July. Marshall actually ripped this page out of my book. But you know, you can really, really plan ahead. It keeps you super organized. And then we get into the I do list, which is its whole separate tab. And this is all the wedding planning stuff. This is just the calendar part. And then here's all the good stuff. So the I do list, literally it gives you some fun advice steps like that. I haven't really like paid attention to that too much. So on this page is, you can, it's like your getting started page. So up here you can have your wedding colors, Down here, you can have your inspo, style, themes, and then important wedding must-haves. Down here, I have my dress written. That's why I'm holding it like this. I have my dress style and the designer. So then it's really cool. It breaks you down into a timeline. So here we have our 14 to 19th month, 14 to 9 months before of what you should be doing. It's a little bit checklist here. And then 8 to 6 months, this is where we are right now because we are at, I think, 6 months. So I have some little note stickers here and just stuff like that. So it breaks it down literally all the way 6 to 4 months, 4 to 2 months. And then 1 month before and week of the wedding. And then here we just have the wedding party. I have all my bridesmaids written down, and because everybody's gonna be in different colored dresses, I have what colors they've been assigned, if they've gotten their dress or not, and then I just have the groomsmen here and what they'll be wearing as well. You can write down phone numbers, measurements, all that kind of stuff for you to have on file. It gives you a section to write your vows. I don't know, I might do a rough draft here, but I don't think I'm gonna be having this up at the altar with me. So, but it's nice to brainstorm. And then here you can work on the guest list. So right now I'm not writing the full guest list in this. We actually have a Google Doc so our families can all edit and that kind of stuff. But like this is for the bachelorette party, bridal shower, rehearsal dinner, just to keep track of who's coming to what. So this is the part that's kind of really helpful. So this is the budget checklist, and I'm covering because obviously I don't want you guys to see numbers. But so it has venue, gown alterations, and it's really nice. It gives you a tab for budget, estimate, and then what you actually spent. So it's really easy to figure out and stay on budget. Our wedding planner did give us access to a site called Aisle Planner, and that is like a detailed spreadsheet of what we're spending. So I lean towards that a little bit more. I don't necessarily use this, but it's nice to kind of quickly write down estimates and stuff when you're meeting with like the cake vendor, the florist, and it's nice to keep track of who I've paid deposits to. That's what I really use this for. But the bulk of the information and our really detailed budget is actually online in that site. Sorry if you can hear the dogs, they're playing. So the next thing that is in here is, it's called Picture This, and these are the important shots. It actually gives you a nice list of some of the photos you might want to have, which is really helpful. So bride with family, bride getting ready, shots of bride's accessories, that kind of stuff. And then other thoughts I have, we're actually going to be doing a first look, so I want the first look. I want a few funny photos, that kind of stuff. And then we have the music list here for the DJ. So then comes your flower section, and I have it broken down for the bridal party, for the ceremony, and then for the reception. So I already did a consultation with our florist, so these are just some notes from our call. And then these are cake notes. And it's really cool. It gives you the cake sizing and how many people it serves as like a little bit of a cheat sheet when they ask whether you want 2 tiers, 3 tiers, etc. So then you can have other sweet treats for the wedding. I wrote down some notes there. And then this will be the section that I write our notes from the cake tasting when we have it. Is your bar and menu tasting. So here again, it breaks down glasses per bottle. So champagne, wine, liquor. So if you need to order individually, you have kind of a cheat sheet there of how much you would actually need depending on how many guests you're inviting. So here's the wedding menu tasting section. You have rehearsal, dinner, reception, and then notes from tastings. So this is gonna be super helpful again when we go and do our menu tasting in a few weeks. So you'll probably see me bring this along and write down some notes. And then we have our vendor contact list, which is so helpful. So we have our officiant, ceremony, reception, caterer, cake baker, florist, musician, photographer, wedding planner. I have the hotel where the rooming block is, the rentals, hair, makeup, linens, all that kind of stuff. So all the contact information I have is here. I don't necessarily have to go through my email digging for phone numbers. And then you do have a section for seating arrangements, which is really helpful. You have the table number, and then you can list all the guests here. We are having a plated dinner with assigned seating, so that will definitely be very helpful when we get to that point, and you actually have a few pages of that if you need it. So then we actually have a gift log here, which again, super helpful for writing thank you notes. This will obviously be further down the line if people choose to bring us a gift. We will keep track of it here. And then gifts to give bridesmaids, groomsmen, mother of the bride, mother of the groom, maid of honor, all that kind of stuff. Any favors. So this will be helpful when planning those items. I actually have already started on all the bridesmaids' gifts and all that. I just haven't written anything down yet. And then it actually gives you a wedding timeline. It says stress-free bride-to-be. And so it starts at 6 a.m. and it goes to 7 p.m. So I have a little list of things to consider here. You know, just things to factor into the timeline, such as transportation for the bridal party, last-minute touch-ups, florist delivery, all that stuff that needs to be coordinated. We actually do have the day of coordination package with our wedding planner. So she will be taking care of a lot of that stuff. Again, I know she knows what she's doing. She's awesome. She's amazing, but it's for my own personal sanity. So then we have honeymoon information. We have not gotten that far yet. And then a little template for writing thank you notes and all that stuff. And then it kind of goes into a little bit of like a memory book, which is cute. So it says like all your memories, you can post photos in there and everything. I don't think I'm going to be using that at all because I don't have time to be cutting out and pasting pictures in here. Like, we got real shit to do. So then I have a list of things here that I need to buy still or that we will need. And then these are things that I'm adding to the list to bring to Raleigh for the actual event. So I have things on here like dress, shoes, gift, cake stand, frames, rehearsal outfit, guest book, welcome bags, decorations, rings, makeup, vlog camera, that kind of stuff that I'm just starting to compile a list. I know we're 6 months out, but I do enjoy planning. This is fun for me. So I've tried to be on top of it as possible because come August, I don't want to be running around with my hair on fire. So yeah, you just have a ton of space for notes. And you know, it's really helpful. You even have blank pages here where you can draw diagrams. I think I'm gonna use that when we do our venue tour again, so that way I can map out where I want certain tables and rentals and things like that. And then the fun part, which you've all been waiting for, in the back you have pages and pages of fun little stickers. So you have like hearts, arrows, things that say celebrate, to do, reminder, important, little email envelopes here, so if you know you need to reach out to someone. And then here you have some additional like note tabs and stuff like that. So I haven't been digging into these too much, but I definitely want to use them more. And then here you have your events mapped out, like hair appointments, shoes, bachelor party, shower, dress fitting, all that kind of stuff. So it's really cute. It's really, really organized and it makes planning super fun. And then in the back here, you have a little bit of a folder. You have one in the back of that as well. And this is just where I have our linen samples and all that in here. From the rental place, they actually gave me swatches of all the fabric, which was really nice. So I just keep like invoices, stuff like that. So yeah, that's pretty much the breakdown of my wedding planner. I found this has just been the easiest and the most detailed for me. And it's made everything really, really smooth. It's all in one. I just have to take one book with me and I'm ready to go. It fits in all my purses. So yeah, it's really, really helpful. And I write everything in there. This is like something just for me. I write everything in there in pencil because things change frequently and I'm a neat freak. I don't like cluttered notes that I can't read and all that kind of stuff. So I definitely write everything in pencil. Like that's it, just a planner and a notepad, and then the online budgeting sheet, our online guest registry kind of list of who we are inviting, who we sent a save the date to. I did organize that so we have access to that information so we don't miss anyone, that kind of stuff. If we have any address changes, a lot of our friends are in the military, so we do have a lot of address changes. So it's just easier to keep that kind of stuff online in like a Google Docs spreadsheet. That's pretty much all the tools I use for planning, and so far they've been working really, really well for me. And if you have any other questions about planners, anything like that, you can go ahead and leave them in the comments below. So thank you so much for watching. This was a fun vlog for me. I love wedding planning, like I said, and I'm getting really excited. We're getting close. So I hope to do a lot more of these vlogs, and I'll see you in my next video. Thank you.
just fine before I met you. I drink too much and that's an issue, but I'm okay.